Next, let's move on to selling, general and admin expenses. Here we'll be capturing all indirect cost, because all the direct cost were captured under, or all the direct expenses were captured over here. So all indirect expenses, indirect cost will come here, selling related, commission, then sales related, marketing related, advertisement cost, then general admin staff, then office power bill, like that, all expenses which are not directly related to the cost of production will come over here. And once we add this with total cost of sales, we get to know what is the overall operating cost. Okay, let's be clear. So far what we had is total cost of production. With that, when we added and subtracted finished goods, we derived total cost of sales. And with that, if you add selling, general and admin expenses, you will get to know what is your operating cost. Okay, let me put that here. Subtotal is basically operating cost. Okay, this is your operating cost. And if you deduct this operating cost, that is item number 7, from your net sales, that is item number 3, what you get is operating profit before interest. Okay, so your net sales minus operating cost will give you operating profit. And selling, general and admin expenses is one critical element here. The past 3 year financials will give you information which you can feed here in the selected sales. With regard to estimate and projection, you have to see what was the trend in the past. And this expenses should not increase significantly, because they are all indirect expenses, not directly related to production. So all these are going to reduce the profit. Entity should have control over these expenses, otherwise it will erode the profit margin, or it will push the entity into loss zone. So effort should be made by the entity to control, and the banker should see what is the trend of this expenses vis-a-vis sale, vis-a-vis total production cost. Okay, if you go to this valid statement, here you can see selling, general expenses as a percentage of sales, because selling expenses are included here, marketing expenses are included here. So it makes more sense to compare it with net sales rather than the cost of production. Okay, and you have to see the percentage. It can be like 5%, 8%. Let's say in 1 year it is 5%, in next year it goes to 20%, in third year it comes back to 6%. It means the year in which it jumped to 20%, you have to look into the reasons. Okay, because this is a kind of a loophole, or it is kind of a funnel where the entity's money will go out of the system. So in the name of marketing expenses, or in the name of fuel expenses for running office car, or in the name of let's say admin or contractual work like that, the money will go out. So if there is going to be a significant jump deviating from the trend, that has to be looked into. So for the past 3 years, what is the percentage of sales? That level more or less can be estimated and projected as well. Okay, so in this way only we estimate and project selling, general and admin expenses. And once we have operating cost, we are in a position to find out operating profit before interest. And take it from me, if an entity is not making operating profit, if an entity is continuously reporting operating loss year after year, year after year, then absolutely there is no point in continuing that business forward. Probably the net profit, they may report a decent positive figure, but if operating profit is loss, see, operating profit is a profit which they get because of running that business. Net profit is a profit which they get because of some other elements over and above your operating profit. It is possible that some entities will report operating loss but positive net profit. How? They got some indirect non-operating income. They got some non-operating income. Non-operating income is not perennial. Non-operating income will not occur, will not come regularly. They are one-off in nature. They are not recurring in nature. So what is important? What is the very purpose of running an organization is to make a profit or to make margins from their core operations. So if operating profits are not positive, in some cases when it is negative, we have to look at the reason why it is negative. Is it substantially on account of depreciation? Then to a certain extent we can console ourselves, because depreciation being a non-cash item, if cash profit is comfortably profitable, if cash profit is comfortably positive, not profitable, if cash profit is comfortably positive, then negative operating profit or operating loss for some period, we can say okay. But on a continuous basis, year after year, if the company, if the entity is reporting operating loss, then they have to do a serious introspection as to why, despite all the efforts, they could not make out. What is the point in running business year after year with accumulating losses? Eventually, that business will get closed down, okay, because of poor performance. So, operating loss is an indication that business has not been run efficiently. So, it should act as a trigger. It should act as a warning signal for the entity, for the owners, as well as the banker, to understand that somewhere there are leak, somewhere there are gaps. All those got to be checked, arrested, and completed now itself. Okay. So that's the significance of operating profit. Okay. And here we have, what is operating profit before interest? It means there is also going to be another operating profit, which is operating profit after interest. We'll see that.